Hello fellow game developers, I hope you're safe and healthy at home. Welcome to the fourth part of the Enemy Melee Combat series. I know I said that this mini series is complete, but I received messages from multiple members that there was some issue while they were trying to make this enemy behavior. And the issue was that whenever you jump, the enemy is going to flip and start walking back to the waypoint. It's like the enemy forgets that the player was even detected in the first place. So we're going to fix that in this video. Let's begin. So first of all, we are going to delete the raycast game object from the enemy parent object and create a new child object. I'm going to call it hot zone and add a new box collider 2D to it. This area is going to work as hot zone, and inside this area the player will remain detected and enemy will keep following the player no matter even if the player jump. You can resize and reposition it according to your choice. So that's what we need to do in Unity for now, and it's time for some. Now we're going to make some quick changes to our existing enemy behavior script. First of all, we're going to get rid of all the raycast variables because we are not using raycast anymore. And we are going to take the target and in-range variables and put them under the public region, and also change them to public variable because we are going to call them from a different script in a moment. And we don't need to see them in the inspector window, so we are going to add hide in inspector attribute in front of them to hide them from inspector window. Along with that, we are going to add two new public variables of game object type, one for newly created hot zone game object and second for our trigger area. Now let's collapse the regions and move forward. Next, we need to remove the functions which are not required because we removed some of the raycast variables. As you can see that we have some statements which are getting red underlined, so we are going to remove them. We are going to check if player is in range or not by some other method, so we are going to remove this if statement from here. Also, we don't need this if else statement either because we are going to check for player exit by a different method. And whenever the in range boolean is true, we are going to call the enemy logic function. We are also going to get rid of onTriggerEnter function because we don't need it anymore, and we don't need raycast debugger function either. Now we just need to make the select target function as public, and same for the flip function because we are going to access them from a different script. That's all we have to do here. So now when we go back to Unity and we are going to select the enemy object, you can see that in the inspector window we have two new fields, hot zone and trigger area. We are going to assign the correct game object to both of them, and now we are going to create a new script for our trigger area object. This will keep things well organized and easier for us. Let's open the script. So this script is going to check when the player enters the range. First of all, we are going to get reference to main script of enemy parent object. So we are going to declare a variable to store the enemy script, and inside the wake function we are going to get reference to it by using get component in parent because the script is attached to enemy parent object. Next, we are going to create a new onTriggerEnter2D function, and inside it we are going to check if the game object which has entered the trigger area has a tag of player. Then we are going to do couple of things inside this if statement. First of all, we are going to deactivate the trigger area object by writing gameObject.setActive false. Next, we are going to access the target variable in the parent script and set it equal to the game object which has entered the trigger area, and also set the inRange boolean in parent script to true so that once the inRange boolean gets true, it will start running the enemy logic function. And we are going to activate the hot zone area, and with that we are done with this script. Let's jump back to Unity and attach this newly created script to trigger area child object. Now we need a new script for our hot zone area, so let's create one. I'm going to name it hot zone check. Inside this script also, we first need to store reference to parent object script, and we need a private boolean variable to make sure that the player is in range, and another variable to store the reference to object's animator component. Now in the wake function, we are going to get reference to the script on parent object and to the animator component which is attached to the parent object. Now we need to check for the presence of player inside this hot zone, and we are going to do that with onTriggerEnter function. And inside it, once the player is detected, we are going to turn inRange boolean to true. Now we are going to come in the update function, and once inrange boolean is true, we are going to call some functions inside it, and we also need to make sure that the enemy is not playing attack animation, because that will look weird. So inside this function, we want the enemy to keep looking in the direction of player, and that's all we have to do in the update function. Now we want to run some conditions when player exit the hot zone. So for that, we are going to use onTriggerExit function, and we are going to check if the game object which has exit the area is tagged player, and if that condition is true, we want to turn inrange boolean to false, and we are going to deactivate the hot zone area, and we are going to activate the trigger area back on. And also we are going to turn the inrange boolean in the parent script to false so that the enemy can go back to patrolling state, and we are going to call the select target function so that the enemy knows to which waypoint to move toward. And with that, we are done with the coding part. Now let's get back to Unity and assign this newly created script to the hot zone object, and make sure to turn on the isTrigger property of the collider. And by default, we are going to keep this hot zone object deactivated because it is going to be turned on only when the enemy enters the range. Now let's play it and see what we have. As you can see, the moment we enter the trigger area, it deactivates itself and activates the hot zone object. And as long as the player stays inside this area, the enemy will keep following the player even if the player jump over the enemy. And the moment we get out of the hot zone, it will deactivate itself and activate the trigger area. And with that, we have a proper enemy which can do melee attack and which can go back to patrolling state. If you find this tutorial helpful, let me know in the comments below, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button to support me, and you can also join the Discord community. The link is in the description below, and I will see you next time with a new type of enemy AI. Until then, bye.